Hey everybody, it is Darin from Lilley's Landing. Today is Saturday, September 23rd. And I'm gonna do the one cast for you today. So I wanted to be up there by Lookout Island, but I haven't been out here in a long time and it is stained water up there. I mean, and normally where you can see the bottom in a couple feet of water, you can't see it. So, and there's a couple of other people up there fishing. Anyway, so I came down here to just blow the tennis courts. And I'm gonna throw a miracle fly under a stick-on indicator. Gotta get some line out here. See what happens. One of the guides was at, Jeremy Rasnick was at the dock when I was leaving. He said they caught a few up here when the wind would blow where they're at. It's kind of a normal thing. Remember where I put the floats here. So we'll see. I came up to this one spot here where there's that drop off and the fish like to hang out, but I can't see. So hoping. Hoping they're here. What happened there? There we go. Yeah, got the camera the right way. We have a yellow miracle fly on. Oh, there's a couple fish right there. Right under the boat. Those are our trout. So it might be kind of in the line of them there. Oh, the water's off right now. I don't know what temperature is, but it's warmer than it has been. Oops. It's actually warm. Other fishing reports, there's a few guys this morning that caught them on night crawlers decently, down, of course, out of the trophy area. And then yellow power bait and orange power bait. But that was early this morning. So I opened the office. So they were in there at 7 o'clock, pretty much right when we opened, right when I opened it. So yeah. I don't know if that was me or if that was fish. Probably me. So if there was real shallow, I can see the bottom, but I was seeing those fish out there under the boat a second ago. I don't want to get up there too far. I actually backed off of it a little bit. Someone eat something off the top over there. They're up there in that shallow stuff. Probably should have brought, I don't know what I should have brought, teed up there. That water up there is 4 or 5 inches deep where I saw those two come up just a second ago. Them. was almost a hook in the face. So the wind's kind of blowing two directions here. It's blowing out and up. Oh, I just had a bite and I didn't. So I had a bite, but the indicator didn't go under. The wind was pushing it that way and it just stopped for a second. I need to nose the boat up there, I guess. So I only brought miracle flies, like I always do. I pick out a fly and then that's all I bring. I brought two of them. A lot of times I just bring one and I end up losing it and then I'm done, but. Float was under, but I don't know if that was a bite or not. It was just staying under. So it might be in the bottom. I can't see the bottom up there very well. So I don't know. So where that fish came up, if you could see it, I don't know, it might be in the way. But that's in that real shallow stuff. One about 3 feet from the bank up there. Man, when I saw those fish, there was like five of them together. I must be getting the bottom. Oh yeah, I am. I think fishing a dry might be better if I had one, because you're not, there's a lot of junk, so. This side's not as bad as the other side. Oh, that was the wave. When I came up through the narrows, Brett Raider was in there and he missed the fish while I was talking to him. I was distracting him, but. There we go. So that bite, I wish there was a way where you guys could see the, for sure see the bite on these, because it's a split second. So it's literally just a, that stick on, it's white and then pink on the outside, but it's just a flicker is all you see. You might not have this turned far enough anyway. There we go. He's a little guy, but it still counts. I bet you this is hot. Let's do this. That was a hook myself. All right. I tried to do it the easy way. I tried being lazy. I shouldn't say the easy way. The lazy way. It just doesn't work. Because I hooked him good. So this fish has some markings on him. Oh, he's got a chunk out. That's what it is. He's swimming good though. Crazy. I wonder what that's from. Because it's scarred up around it too, like it was bigger and healed up. That went for a swim right there. Fish right underneath the boat again. A little shallower. Shallows up, I think, right there. Yeah. So my float just slowly went underwater, which it was just, my fly was sitting on the bottom. Trout right here. 6 inches under the surface. He looks pretty good. He's going towards my float, towards my indicator. Go down to the bottom, buddy. There, eat it, eat it. So he literally swam under my float and he hit my line, so my fly was moving. So I pulled it. Just a little bit, not to set the hook, but just to move it. And he saw the fly come up, so he chased it. And then when it started sinking, he gave up on it. But he was only that far below the surface. That's how I could see him. It's warm. I was hoping we were done with this, but I'm ready for 50 degrees every day. The high 50 degrees, I should say. Yeah, I bet you if I had, Phil, I think he fished some small dries, like little beels or something on a couple of them. I think they would eat that up there. Because they're pretty active up there. They're more active up there than they are out here. Scoot up a little bit here. Fly looks good. Trying to let that be still as long as I can reach. That was a fish. If you could see that, it was just a little flicker. It might be pointing into the sun now. Of course, right where we came through one just. Oh, that was horrible. Come on. That was just the bottom. So the difference was it went under slowly. I thought I wasn't in very shallow water, but I guess it was. That one was a fish. Hearing being noisy. Love all the noises out here. Now it's hard to tell because there's a little bit of chop. So if the fish just makes it flicker, it just looks like one of the little waves. It flickered before that and I couldn't tell, but that he pulled it under and it stayed under like a normal bite. He's not fighting too hard. Oh, there he goes. Not very big, but bigger than the last one. Pull him off if I keep horsing too much. Come on. Got fly line everywhere. Make sure that one's the net. All right. A little healthier looking one. No holes in that one. Well, except for the hook hole. All right, well, I think that'll do it. I'm hot already. Thanks for watching, everybody. Have a good day. Let me get untangled here.